What's up guys, I'm PhoenixMaster1 and welcome back to my unit review series for Fire Emblem Heroes, and today we're going to be taking a look at Mad King.
How wonderful, stealing my thunder.
So these are the topics I'm going to be talking about in this video, and the timestamps are going to be in the seek bar as well as in the description. So let me know what you think about Gangrel and if you're going to be building him up, and with that said, let us begin. Gangrel is an infantry colorless dagger unit with Levin Dagger because he has got Levin Sword on his belt and he's too cool to use that right now. So his stats are pretty decent for a dagger unit, having pretty high speed at base 38, having 32 base attack, and having pretty high HP at 45, which is quite unusual. And he also has decent mixed bulk at 24 defense and 30 resistance, and this gets better with his weapon. His weapon is Levin Dagger, which is a 14 might exclusive weapon that gives him plus 3 resistance, which is really good with the secondary effect of this weapon. If any kind of negative penalty like debuffs or panic or something similar to that is active on the foe, then it grants plus 4 to all of his stats during the combat, and he deals 20% true damage based off his resistance. So at first, by looking at the secondary effect, you might think that this is not really all that good because Gangrel doesn't have the highest resistance. But keep in mind, just unmerged with his base kit, Gangrel is able to reach 34 resistance with his weapon's effect active. So he's able to have 6 true damage per hit. And we can easily compare this to weapons of Flying Nino, Karla, and Nesala. All of these weapons give them true damage based on their speed. And Gangrel has got a better weapon than all of these because these weapons have got a hard cap of plus 7 true damage, and there's no cap on Gangrel's true damage, so that is really great. And another thing why Gangrel's weapon is better is that he's not comparing his stats with an enemy. You just have to resistance stack on him, give him high resistance basically, and he can get true damage. But these units do have to compare their speed stat with the enemy, and the difference of that is gonna be their true damage, which can vary because enemy units can be really fast. And as of late, Faye has been releasing some really fast units. So if you consider any of the weapons of these units strong, then Gangrel is gonna be no different. If anything, as I explained before, this is better. And the primary effect of this weapon, which works off based on the penalty present on the foe, is extremely easy to trigger because we've got so many options to debuff the enemies, sabotage skills, ploy skills, we have got shrine structures in Aether Raids, not to mention you could use allies like Tethys, who can run Temari Dagger, Air, who can run Temari Dagger, Aversa, Clarice, who does have the new weapon refined, that's really good. You could even pair him up with Layla, who can provide the debuffs and then swap places with him. So there are so many options to just give debuff to the enemy so that he can have this weapon's effect active right on his first combat. And even if you don't run him with those allies, because daggers inherently have the minus 7 defense and resistance debuff, against a second encounter against the next foe who has been debuffed, he's gonna be having this weapon effect active. So this is a very solid weapon, and it's pretty easy to trigger. It also gives him true damage, which is a cherry on top because he doesn't have the highest attack, so he definitely appreciates this true damage. He has got Chill Attack and Panic Ploy, which is nothing new because units have got the skill before. In fact, Conrad and Garnev both had Chill Attack, and Walter and Garen also have Panic Ploy. So I really hope Intelligent Systems can give us skills which have not been present on Grail units before. He has got Glacies, which is definitely a decent special for him, but Iceberg, Moonbow Glimmer are also pretty decent. And the main comparison of him is gonna be Kronia, who's another Grand Hero Battle unit. And Kronia is an extremely popular merge project and one of the best Grails units in the game because of her Athame Dagger. So if you look at the stat spread here, Gangrel obviously has more BST than Kronia, so he ends up having a bit more bulk and he has got one more attack point in exchange for having one less speed. And that is really good. Also, the fact that Levin Dagger can give him defense and resistance during combat makes him more bulky than Kronia, and Kronia only gets attack and speed from her dagger. Her dagger though is extremely good for vantage sweeping strategies because if the opponent is damaged, then she gets the vantage effect right off the bat, and that is pretty easy to set up with having Savage Blow. But of course, Healing Tower in Aether Raids is gonna be creating a problem. But because Kronia has got Vantage built into her weapon, her slot B is open so she can run stuff like Disarm Trap to easily snipe some really hard to snipe healing towers. Not to mention you could easily support her with someone like Halloween Hector or Fallen Takumi to provide the extra damage. But in general, Kronia is going to be the more consistent Vantage user. And Kronia has definitely stood the test of time for almost a year now. So she's definitely a pretty good unit. However, Gangrel is going to be out damaging her because of the true damage. And the fact that he can have more bulk is definitely going to be a pretty nice thing. So still, like, I think Kronia is slightly better because of having Athame and having Vantage built into it. And she can run stuff like Special Spiral, Null Counter Disrupt, or Disarm Trap for Aether Rates in the slot B. But Gangrel does have that true damage, can out-damage her pretty much, and he's a pretty strong unit in his own right. I really want to make this comparison because of the fact that how hilarious and sad it is at the same time. So Gaius got his weapon refined 2 months back, and Gangrel completely slammed dunks on him because he has got superior stats than Gaius. He has got more stats on his weapon based on the primary effect. And Gangrel also has true damage, and he can get more true damage really easily by stacking up resistance compared to Gaius. So it just goes to show you that Intelligent Systems needs to put more effects on these Gen 1 units because they need the help very desperately. Overall, Gangrel is a pretty good unit and one of the better free double units that we have got. The true damage is definitely really, really good, and you can easily resistance stack on him. And he doesn't have that bad of a bulk with his weapons effect active, and if you invest highly into him, that high HP definitely does favors for him, as you will see later on with the builds. And the primary effect of his weapon is extremely easy to trigger with good allies. The only thing which I dislike about Gangrel is that he's got 166 BST, which means that after the first merge, he's not able to reach 170 BST, and if you want to use him in arena, then he's forced to run Colorless Dual Infantry, which is definitely not that good. So I just wish they gave him 167 BST over 166. That would have been so perfect, and that could have provided more value to the free-to-play players who are going to be investing into him, because he could have been used in arena as well as a score stick.
Back for your life!
His first build is a good old Fury Desperation build, which is a budget build. Fury does increase his offenses as well as his resistance, so this can give him 8 true damage per hit, just unboosted. He's of course recommended to run with a unit who can provide him with resistance buff in form of Res Tactic or any of those other skills. The next budget build is using Swift Sparrow and Flashing Blade, so he does have pretty good speed to utilize this. So he can get 6 true damage per hit, and he can also trigger Glimmer when he's in the Desperation range. Another budget build utilizes Mirror Strike from Oliver. So Mirror Strike does give you the resistance and also the attack, and you can combine this with Swift Sparrow Sacred Seal to have 7 true damage per hit and still having pretty decent offenses. Another budget build he has got is a Fury Vantage build. Obviously, this kind of build really appreciates the merges so that he can get more stats in general, but this build as it is going to be providing you with 9 true damage per hit, and Brazen Attack Resistance is a really, really good Sacred Seal for him. And now we move on to some of the expensive builds for him. So this build is utilizing his AoE damage. Now the true damage gets added into the AoE damage, so despite not having the highest attack, he can still function as an AoE spammer basically with Special Spiral. And you don't really have to run Life and Death on a slot A because it reduces his true damage, so I feel like Fury 4 is the best option overall. So with this he can get 8 true damage per hit, and Flashing Blade is required so that you can set up your Special Spiral and just abuse the AoE special. Mirror Impact is a really, really good skill for Gangrel with the type of weapon that he has got, because it provides him with massive plus 10 resistance in the player phase. And when you combine that with his weapon and his stats, then he is able to get 10 true damage per hit with this skill. So that is really, really amazing, and that can just help him reach the Desperation range much easily against some really threatening opponents. Attack Res Push is also a pretty good skill that could be run on him, and the only problem I have with the skill is that because of his high HP, he's not able to fall into the Desperation range after just 2 combats, but instead he takes 3 combats, so that's something you have to consider, but still an option nonetheless. Attack Res Solo can also be run with something like Vantage, and this is present in both phases, so this is kind of similar to the Push build, but just has the tier 4 solo skill. And this is definitely pretty strong on him. Now, this build is utilizing Flashing Blade 4 and just wants to have more true damage on him. So because of his high speed, he can pretty much get 52 speed unboosted at high investment. And that is just really optimal to use Flashing Blade 4 in the slot A. So Flashing Blade 4 does give you 5 extra true damage, and with the true damage he gets from his weapon, that can combine to be a total of 13 true damage per hit, And Time Pulse allows him to have Iceberg as a 2-turn cooldown special at start of every turn, so it could trigger that in the Desperation and get even more damage output. Now, we're going to be taking a look at Gangrel from the Aether Raid's perspective. As I said before, Gangrel is definitely a pretty good unit to be used in Aether Raids, just like Cronia. And in the Light Season, I would say that he's better because he can get resistance from Air, and Air can also provide him with the Temari Dagger effect. So if you use Cronia already, Cronia could be put on the Astra Season, and then Gangrel could be put on the Light Season. So he's able to have 52 resistance with this build and get 10 true damage per hit, which is really, really good for Vanta sweeping, especially because he's able to reach 62 attack unboosted with this build. The thing which is really good about Gangrel is that he has got high HP and really good mixed bulks, so it actually makes it easier for him to get into the Vantage range by surviving like pure combat, because he's not gonna get one shot a lot of the times, and having that high HP at high investment basically makes it so that Gangrel can avoid most of the level 5 Panic Manors and Tactic Rooms. And Panic Manor can go up to level 7, but like against those teams who don't have that upgraded, you could easily avoid it by having 61 HP, which Gangrel is able to reach. So this is definitely an advantage of having extra HP compared to Cronia. He can have even more expensive build for Aether Raids in form of Close Foil and Pulse Smoke. So this build uses triple mythic units, and triple mythic setup is really, really common in Light Season because the light mythic units like Air, Peony, and Mila just provide so much utility and so many roles that you don't really need any other support units. So you could just have 3 mythic units, have your core unit, and just have a bonus unit. And this allows your core unit like Gangrel to get really, really bulky and be more powerful. And if you summoner support him, then he's completely immune to level 7 Panic Manor. And any of the buildings at lower level is obviously going to be no problem for him. Now, you might ask, he is meant to be a Vantage unit, how is that relevant? The thing is that at the first combat, when he's gonna be at full HP, he can avoid even Panic Manors, which are hard to snipe because of his high HP. So that is definitely a pretty good thing. And Close Foil does give him extra attack and extra defense, which is just gonna be adding to his bulk. And with triple mythic units, Gangrel is actually quite bulky, having 71 HP, 44 defense, and 54 resistance. That is no joke. And when you combine that with Pulse Smoke, like, he can easily survive Infantry Pulse team with no problem. And Mila, of course, can provide the isolation effect, which can make it even easier for you to sweep the teams by just preventing the dancers from just stepping in. In the future, whenever the resistance version of Close Foil is going to get released, which I think is going to be called Close Ward, that could give him one extra true damage, so that could be done. And once again, because of his high HP, he can be utilized in Aether Raid's defense because he can be an Infantry Pulse support unit on an Infantry Pulse team. And he can himself be a pretty annoying unit to face because of his bulk and how high resistance he can actually get with Mirror Impact. So Mirror Impact is by far the best skill for him if you want to use him in Aether Raid's defense. And Quicken Pulse makes Iceberg into a 2-turn cooldown special, so he can trigger that in a single round of combat against a foe who can retaliate. In Anima Season, he's pretty good because he could get resistance from Mirabilis, and Mirabilis can also provide the attack debuff from Whimsical Dream, so that could just help him on his first initiation. And the final showcase is, I guess, the meme build. Don't really take this too seriously, I just wanted to showcase the highest true damage he can get. Hopefully I didn't mess it up, but basically if you have Mirror Impact, the plus 6 resistance buff, Brazen Attack resistance, and if you're supporting him with 3 airs, he can reach 80 resistance to get 16 true damage per hit. So that's just to showcase his peak damage output. Definitely not an optimal thing that he should run, but I just felt like adding this in.
Eeny, meeny, moe!
Gangrel is going to be costing you 2,200 drills if you decide to plus and merge him before his rerun. And his rerun is probably going to be happening in like 6-7 months. So if you plus and merge him at that point, then you're going to be requiring only 1,750 grails. So that is really good for saving the cost of the grails. And Gangrel is a pretty good dagger unit who has got the true damage niche, and he can function in both phases as you saw with the builds. And it's not really all that hard to resist and stack on him to get even more true damage. And he can be quite versatile, and he can function as a Vantage Sweeper in Aether Raids, and he can be pretty good at that role. And the high HP and the extra stats he gets from his weapon does make him pretty decently bulky. Now, the thing is that he faces immense amount of competition from someone like Cronia, and as explained before, she can run other slot B skills while also having Vantage. And another thing is that he's not able to reach 170 PST, so he's not able to have the optimal scoring in arena without a dual skill. So that really, really sucks. But overall, Gangrel is a pretty good unit, and I can definitely see a lot of people investing into him because of how fun he can be just with the true damage shenanigans and how easy it is to stack up the resistance on him to get even more true damage and just how versatile overall he can be. So that is gonna be it for my review. I hope you guys enjoyed. I wanna thank all of my YouTube members for their support. And if you enjoyed this video, please be sure to leave a like and a comment. Helps me tremendously. And share this video with your friends who are thinking of building up Gangrel. And be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell because YouTube sub boxes are about as functional as Gaia's after seeing Gangrel. So with that said, I'll see you guys next time. Thank you so much for watching and have a great day.